So welcome to the lab. Here we have three diamond growing machines that use plasma generated with hydrogen and carbon inside the chambers here. And they're actually used to grow diamonds layer by layer, extremely pure, and for technological quantum and microelectronics applications.
One of the big challenges for growing quantum diamond is that you really need separate reactors and process control to be able to try different things. This allows us to be much more playful and creative in terms of pushing the boundaries of diamond growth than you can typically do in a lab.
In the quantum world, we're really interested in materials that exhibit properties that we can use that are also really exotic and enabling. And in the quantum land, that means it does things that you don't expect and then you're not used to. And for us, the great thing about diamond is that it can exhibit those properties and we can make these quantum devices to do things like being in two places at once at room temperature. So the best example I have is if I take a diamond lattice full of carbon atoms and I make it pure, but I replace one of the atoms with something else, then I can actually look at the two electrons that move around that site and I can ask those electrons questions like, where are you? How much energy do you have? And they will exhibit quantum properties that are not only amazing, but that I can actually measure and see at room temperature on a bench.
This national lab in particular is a really invaluable resource for this kind of research because of the deep expertise in plasma science. It's really hard to imagine doing this really anywhere else. And this collaboration has just opened up completely new research opportunities that I wouldn't have thought of otherwise. The only way to grow quantum gray diamond is with plasma. So what we're trying to do is now bring plasma physics into quantum diamond growth to really push the boundaries of what's possible.
So we've got two diamond growing machines here. They're actually both the same machine, but we're using them for two different purposes. So we've got one machine where we're using extremely high purity carbon and hydrogen to grow extremely high purity diamond. And the higher the purity, the better it is for certain quantum and microelectronics applications. And then in the second machine, we're actually deliberately adding different dopants. So it looks the same, but we have different gases flowing in here. And we're deliberately doing that to change the properties of the diamond. And when we combine these two things together, then we can make some really interesting quantum and microelectronics devices.
This is a really critical step forward in making sure that we have domestic capabilities to grow state-of-the-art material.
If you look at the plasma generated in here, you'll see that the color tells you about what's happening. And it tells you about the fact that it's a very high temperature gas. It's very hot. And what that heat allows us to do is chemistry that doesn't normally happen in a room temperature environment. So if we look at the next machine, the next thing we need to do is really control and understand the plasma so that we can make the better diamond. So follow me. The reason we've got a third machine here is we really need to understand the details of what's happening inside that plasma. This machine is configured very nicely for us to be able to really peer inside the plasma with the diagnostics tools that we have available to follow that plasma, look at the plasma and understand the plasma and use that to make better diamond.
I think we're living through a really exciting, fast-paced time where people are now building larger and larger technologies. Labs like the Quantum Diamond Lab have a big role to play in providing these very highly controlled, exquisite material environments for these quantum technologies.
Thanks for joining us in the lab today. I'd love to talk more to you about science in the future. Thank you.